Please read this disclaimer. This video's all the character and all of its contents, including any disease and opinions expressed by the narrator, are strictly for entertainment purposes only. And it is not intended in any way as a substitute for professional service and consultation from licensed therapist, doctor, attorney, or other licensed professional service provider. Each person must make their own life decision, and those decisions are theirs. Hey listeners, welcome back to another out of the world news story with Revolving Time. Today's tale is about my marriage problems started completely innocently and unexpectedly. Without any evidence that my dear wife was into something unexpected with another man, I could not tell her I was using satellites and her own phone to spy on her doings. Well, my friends, go to the story and see what happened in there. We, my wife Lisa 36, our children Emil 10 and Stella 8, and I, Lucas Franzen 37, were an average Scandinavian small town. We had a house, a Volvo V70, and a dog. Lisa and I met at a party, fell in love, married 12 years ago, and she is still a good-looking woman but in no way outstanding among her middle-class friends. Our relationship was like many others, some ups, some downs, but never any real problems, neither economic or in our sex life. I never suspected Lisa was doing anything behind my back, and I had no intentions of doing something behind her back myself. Nobody knows if such rare things as perfect families really exist, but if so, my family must have been rather close to that. Of course, we weren't living in some soap bubble and received many insights into unexpected relationship problems when several friends and acquaintances parted for different reasons. The worst of them was when the wife next door was caught in her bed with her married boss, who happens to be a cousin of my wife. The fact that the ex-neighbor Anton Larson was and still is my best friend and his wife Emma was good friend with Lisa gave us a complete view into both our friends and my wife's cousin's divorces. Update: my own problems began in a totally innocent and unexpected way. Lisa works one Saturday a month, which is compensated for, with free time after lunch every Wednesday. She really likes that deal so she can take care of her many errands while the kids are at school. That Wednesday, I remembered that I had forgotten to ask her about doing an errand for me. So I tried call her at our home phone after lunch but got no reply. I thought she was out and called her cell phone also without getting a reply, which made me slightly confused. We had recently bought identical new advanced smartphones. Lisa's main tool was the high-class camera that she used a lot for including pictures to the large number of messages she sent to friends and relatives. She cared less for most of the many other factory-included functions, several of them undeletable junk apps. I myself was more curious about all the possibilities and took my time to try most of those apps. Now, I thought was the right time to use an app, which would show me in a satellite picture where Lisa's phone was at that very moment. I had expected her to be at the mall or in the town center shopping area, but to my surprise, I could see she was in or at a house just outside of town. 1 hour later, I could see she was still there, but the third time I looked, she was in the supermarket where we shopped. Back home after the job, when I asked why she hadn't taken my call, she took up the phone, looked at her missed calls and said, "Very strange, indeed. Because most of that time I was at the mall, together with Lena Norden, looking for a new skirt that I need to buy. Did you find any?" I asked. "No, but I hope for better luck the next time. Do you intend to spend the whole weekend in fashion shops?" She smiled and replied, "No, it can wait until next Wednesday." I didn't make any further comments, but knew for sure that Lisa had told me a lie. That started a warning bell ringing in my head. The next day after work, I took a drive past the place where she had been the day before. It was on a road a short distance out of town, with forest on one side and houses on the other. There were good distances between the houses, so there couldn't be any doubt about the correct address where she had been. Then it was a piece of cake for me to find out that a schoolteacher by the name of Tommy Om was the owner and living in that house. Further searching about him on the official sites on the web showed that he was 35 years old and had gotten a final divorce from a marriage without children only 3 months ago. He didn't work in our children's school, so it could hardly have been any school matters that had brought Lisa to his house. So, whatever her reason was to see this Tommy Om at his home, it must have been some kind of private matter that she preferred not to tell me. Without any evidence that my dear wife was into something unexpected with that Om, I could not tell her I was using satellites and her own phone to spy on her doings. And neither could I accuse her of lying to me without getting further information about what she was into with this teacher, since it could be something totally innocent. Update 1. Next week on her free Wednesday afternoon, I was better prepared when the app in my phone showed that she was at his house again. I took off from my job for a couple of hours and pretended to be a bird watcher in the forest on the opposite roadside from Om's house. Nobody saw me there hiding in the tight bush, but my binoculars gave me a perfect view of the target. Though it was obvious that Lisa's phone was in that house, I couldn't see her car, only his Audi. I rang Lisa's cell phone, and when she replied after several rings, I asked, "Are you at the mall or going there today?" "Yes, I'm in a fashion shop at the mall." "Why are you asking me that?" "Because I've hurt my back this morning. I wondered if you could buy me a jar of Tiger Balm at the pharmacy there at the mall." "Of course, my darling. I love you for that," I said, while my thought was, what a lying bitch. About an half hour later, Lisa and a man came out from the house, got into his car, and after a quick kiss in the front seat, they drove away. Now it was clear to me that I had witnessed a part of a dirty game. It was not too difficult to imagine what had happened in the house. I went back to my job, stayed 1 hour late to calm down, and when back home, I had Lisa massage my back with the Tiger Balm she had bought. Though there was no real problem with my back, it was a good excuse to avoid having sex with her. Now it was high time to make plans to stop this farce. After some thinking, my decision was clear. I would do it alone. But if Anton Larsen offered to help me, it would be even better. When Anton heard about my problems, he shook his head several times and said, "I would never think that Lisa would do the same to you that Emma did to me. She must have gone crazy. She really must be totally nuts for terminating a marriage as good as yours." Then he suggested to me what to do and offered to get me what I needed to do it. I accepted. Who knew Lisa's intentions with Tommy Om? Have a short time affair? Or did she really love him and was waiting for the right time to dump me? For me, it didn't matter. She had already soiled our marriage much more than I could take with my honor left intact. My dear wife had a strange look on her face when I declined her invitations for sex both Friday and Saturday evenings due to my aching back. I promised to see a doctor if the back wasn't better on Wednesday, so that put her in a slightly better mood. Update 2. The next Wednesday was an exciting day. Both my friend Anton and I had taken off from our jobs after lunch and now were sitting in his brother's car. We were parked slightly off the main road, only a short distance from Tommy Om's house. Our main interest was focused on the display of my smartphone, which showed that Lisa's phone had been at the mall for almost 1 hour, and now was in the mall main parking lot. Then it began moving in our direction. "That bitch intends to do it again," I said. Anton nodded but didn't say anything. We guessed Lisa had eaten lunch at one of the restaurants in the mall, and now Tommy Om had picked her up for their love session. We gave them slightly more than 15 minutes in the house before we parked in his driveway. Since the door was locked, we rang the bell. Nothing happened. We rang again, and this time a male voice shouted, "Who are you? What do you want?" Anton replied in a loud voice, "The electric power company. We have to check your meter. It will only take a minute." After a slight delay, the door was opened by a man in a black velvet dressing gown. That was the start signal for our action. Anton dot 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 the man. I rushed past them into the house with a 5-liter plastic drum in my right hand, searching for the bedroom, which I found a few seconds later. The sight in there put the definitive full stop to my marriage. In the bed, I could see Lisa trying to hide under the sheet. Without saying a word, I unscrewed the cap from my drum and poured some of its contents, a terrible stinking mix of pig dot, over the pile of male and female clothes on a chair. Then Lisa screaming and ran into the bathroom and locked the door. I continued pouring a fair amount of the stinking mixture on the very expensive looking bed, then some in a wardrobe and some on the soft carpet before I left the room. Back at the front door, Anton was still holding down the man on the floor. When Anton saw me, he stood up and shouted to the man on the floor, "Try to move and I will dot your balls." Before we left, Anton warned on that the local vigilance committee would punish him if he or Lisa contacted the police. The local vigilance committee became well known after an action some time ago when a notorious drunk driver was found chained to a lamppost early on a Sunday morning outside a former police station. For some reason, it had taken a long time for the police patrol from the county capital to get there. And as they didn't know anybody in town, it had taken an even longer time for them to find a locksmith to cut off the chains. That episode was well written about in our local newspaper. Tommy Om understood what could happen and didn't dare to challenge the committee. Lisa stayed away from home until Saturday morning, when she brought her parents with her. She signed the divorce papers without any arguing and packed up her clothes and other personal belongings. To my great relief, she didn't try any blah blah such as, "It was not what you thought it was," or "I'm sorry, it was a big mistake." We even agreed about our children and the sharing of our bank accounts. Thus was ended our once upon a time happy marriage of 12 years. Final update. Now it has been 9 weeks since I found my wife Lisa in Tommy Om's bed, and our divorce will be final in about 4 months. My life is still in a terrible turmoil, and I'm sure it will take a long time for me to return to a normal life again. Lisa is living with her parents, and Om has moved into his house again. He had been living in a rented trailer on his front lawn while his home was restored after the stinking. The love story between Lisa and Tommy Om lasted only 3 weeks after she left our house. She never moved into his trailer or his house and spent only some nights there. These became fewer and fewer every week. Cheating might be an exciting and romantic experience, but having a real relation with the lover isn't always the main highway to happiness. At least it wasn't for my soon-to-be ex-wife. The gossip from Lisa's friends says that she and Tommy Om had a fling when Lisa and three other wives spent a long weekend in Barcelona, Spain, 2 years ago. And then they happened to meet again when he got a job and bought a house in our town after his wife left him. Her friends even said that a divorce from me had never been the goal for Lisa. She had only regarded Tommy Om as a once-in-the-lifetime a romantic fling and had intended to stop it the week before my action. But he had persuaded her to meet him one more time, which she now regretted. But she didn't know it had already been too late to save our marriage, even a week earlier. However, today she knows one thing for sure: the stench of cheating quickly wafts through the air and gets caught. Let's see how the community reacts, the first one. I've always said that people wouldn't put up with the betrayal or lying from a friend, so how could you put up with it from a wife? Just like you wouldn't want the negativity like that from a friend, you excise them from your life. No point in staying with someone like that. Next person times in. Good, interesting story. The main question for the story is to ask the now divorced wife, Lisa, why did she have sex twice separated by a few years when initially she and he were married but to different people? Why did she continue years later? Obviously, this was no romantic fling. She never said she was in love with her duck toy. Anyone with any sense at all knew to him she was just an easy piece of his and past her prime but eager. The reason that they were not able to sustain anything other than a sexual relationship, and then only for a few weeks after Lisa was kicked out of her home. In truth, they only had a sexual relationship that was devoid of love, affection, caring, and in no other way did they share any of life's other significant experiences. For these two, other than ducking each other, they had nothing else in common. Of course, the title for being the absolute stupid person in this story goes to wife-turned-slut, Lisa. How well will a divorcee do on the single meat market when she is past her prime and can't be trusted in the next relationship? Someone else from community says, keep them coming, would like to see what lead up to her cheating. Why is the marriage unrepairable? He should have talked to her and put her on a short leash. Why do women cheat when it almost always ends badly? The guy usually foots the bill for her cheating. I knew my wife was cheating, so I took some measures to keep my wealth. I am still friends with her but live in separate houses. If you act in haste, it will cost you. Keep your emotions in check. Someone else says, a different kind of revenge, but still a good way to get revenge on a cheating wife. Thank you for being a part of our journey, and we look forward to sharing more powerful stories with you in the future. We encourage you to subscribe to our channel and stay connected with our community. Remember, this channel exists because of your support, and I want it to be a place where we can all come together, learn, and have a great time. Your feedback is vital, and I appreciate every single suggestion and comment you provide. Take care of yourself and see you soon.